Hey guys, welcome back to One Man's Tracks, and we're back with another episode of Goodwill Dumping. And today I've got three more albums that are heading on back to the thrift shop. They aren't terrible albums, so I figured they might be more your style, and at least some of these tracks are certainly worth checking out. So without further ado, let's jump right into them, with the first one being the second album from Boot Sauce, Canadian band out of Montreal. This is the 1992 release Bull through Vertigo Records. They are a bit of an eclectic rock band, trying a ton of different stylings. So, for example, you start off with Love Monkey Number 9, which is a funk rock, sort of hair rock mashup song, and then Touching Cloth is a song that feels like the Beastie Boys mashed up with the Chili Peppers. You go through a few more of the tracks, and it kind of feels like the band is a bit of a Canadian extreme, where they do a bunch of different rock styles, and they have the same vocalist throughout, so there is that level of consistency there, but it's all over the place besides that, and I don't really care much for most of the opening tracks until you get all the way down to. It's more of an instrumental track if you don't count the vocal sampling that they do. It's darker, the sampling itself is naughtier, and it's really interestingly done. Cool electronic dance track. One of my favorites here. They've got Roller Coaster's Child that uses a piece of a song. I can't remember who does the original, but the Chili Peppers actually do a cover of it. And these guys do it better, maybe minus the Flea's super funky bass edition. These guys put a lot of emphasis on the bass here, but you can't top the master of Flea here, so it's mostly a little bit shy of pretty much every band they almost copy on this thing. My favorite track, I think, is the closer. It's Hold Tight, and it actually has a Lemmy feature on it, of all people. I don't know how they swung that, but it's a rockin' closing track that I almost didn't even get to just because it's a little all over the place. The album, especially the first half, is so inconsistent. It's not really something I go for when I'm looking for an album. So when they fell short on a lot of their attempts at sort of revamping different styles that they've been influenced by, I kind of lost a bit of interest. So Boot Sauce, not my style, but an interesting band out of the late 80s, early 90s in Canada that had a couple of hits on the radio, and maybe you remember them, and maybe they're worth revisiting. So I've linked the songs I liked as well as the full album down below, and let's jump on to the next one that's going to the dump. This next one might not make me that many fans by including it in this segment. It's a platinum-selling album by Toad and the Wet Sprocket. This is Dulcinea, maybe Dulcinea, I can't tell you the pronunciation. I've tried to get into Toad and the Wet Sprocket a couple times. I picked up this album, just like cool album art, kind of neat names, Flying from Heaven, Wood Burning. They're nice, pleasant, sort of Christian rock tracks. They're not terrible. Something's Always Wrong, I think, showed up in a TV show. That's kind of a good definition of a lot of their songs. It's good TV show music, kind of light, consistently inobtrusive, and I can't keep my attention on it. I lose focus whenever I try to get through it. It's not something that grips me at all. There's no urgency in any of the instrumentals, so as nice as the pop rock tracks are, they feel listless, and I can't help but feeling bored by halfway through. I can appreciate some of the writing. Glenn Phillips does some good stuff on tracks like, oh, Reincarnation Song. Got a great stripped back feeling. The vocals are good. Windmills is nice. Crowing is a good it, lyrically, but just still that boring, listless pop rock that doesn't feel like it goes anywhere. So I know somebody else would definitely enjoy this more than I do, so it's the next one to head off to the shop. The last album is the Smithereens' second album, Green Thoughts, through Capitol Records in 1988. Their brand of music sits kind of awkwardly between a classic rock influence and a new wave influence. They have a tonally consistent sound, but for me, it's kind of gutless, and I can't be bothered to listen to this anymore. Sure, Only a Memory's a decent opener. House We Used to Live In is a bit of a heartfelt new wave bop. Drowning My Tears is decent but derivative, as well as If the Sun Doesn't Shine has this Beach Boy flavor that's not terrible, but I think this album's better suited for my dad than me, so maybe, Dad, if you don't know about the Smithereens, try this out. If anyone does know about the Smithereens and thinks they've got something better to offer, let me know, because that one's going back to the thrift shop along with the rest, and I'll be dumping them off soon. If you guys know any songs by any of those other bands that I need to check out, maybe an album that I will overlook, let me know in the comments down below. There's way too much music for me to get hung up on these albums that I don't really get a ton of enjoyment out of, and I don't have a whole lot of space to store them. So I'm saying goodbye to a few more albums. Hopefully they'll find a better home. In the meantime, I really do enjoy these two albums I've fully dove into and recommended. Little retrospective reviews of the artists there. I recommend you trying those out, as well as liking the video for making it all the way to the end. Hit this link to subscribe to join me for more next time. Thanks for watching.